I feel super excited because I'm being awarded, and as a survivor who never had a voice when she was mutilated, today I feel like it's the beginning of a hope for all women survivors of FGM and even any other form of gender-based violence. To all women in Tana River, Kenya and Africa and even globally, I feel we are getting there, because as we celebrate the International Women's Day, we are saying every voice of a woman counts. Even those innocent girls should be protected from female genital mutilation. I don't wish any other girl to go through the pain and suffering I experienced when I was an innocent little girl without a voice.
And what are some of it?
When I was a small girl at the age of 10, you know, my age mates will mock me and tell me I'm not clean, I'm not perfect, and I'm not a woman enough to play with them. You know, you are always abandoned, you're always discriminated. There is a lot of stigma and pressure from your age mates and even the community. And women in my community will call you a certain name which you will never wish to be called. They call bara. Bara is like a sewage stinking, something like that. So you feel you should go through mutilation. And for me, I was so much excited to go through FGM. But unfortunately, the regret starts after it has been done. And FGM is irreversible. You cannot change the situation anymore. It happened, it has happened. So there is a total deception, because FGM entails the razor. Some use even knives, and there is bloodshed. There is no way you can become clean. So the cleanliness they are talking about is a total betrayal and deception altogether. For me, I was expecting maybe they will wash me so that I will become clean. And FGM will never increase your age. So the way they are saying you will become a woman is a total lie again. So now that I have my brains, I'm mature enough to know what is right and wrong, they decided to say it's enough. And I felt the pain when I started giving birth to my first daughter. When it happened to me, you know, when you are an innocent child, you don't even know whether it was right or wrong. But afterwards, during my delivery, that's when I felt FGM follows you all your life. You know, I had to be cut by traditional birth attendants for me to pass my daughter. And when I fainted, I didn't even know I was existing anymore. I gave up on life. But when I opened my eyes and I saw God gave me a daughter, and I called to myself, actually, God has sent me a signal to save other girls from what I experienced. And I said to my mother, "Mom, you know what? You failed to protect me, but I protect my daughter. She will never go through FGM." Then I wanted to grab my daughter, and I couldn't do so because of the wound. I thought maybe I can just sit properly and maybe hold my daughter and kiss her, but I was unable to do that because of the pain. You know, I cannot sit properly anymore. And for me, at once I told my mother, you know what? What happened to me was never right, and it should stop. Then the complications continued. My second daughter, again, I had to go through a lot. And the myth and misconceptions was, if I go to the hospital, it's even worse.